Jain, we are from River Narmada and we are here to give the presentation on the topic Dream 11, Rise of Dream 11. Next, play the video.
Here's an advertisement of Dream 11.
आपको क्या लगता है? इंडिया में सिर्फ एक ही धोनी ये है ड्रीम 11 इंडिया का बिगेस्ट स्पोर्ट्स गेम तो अपनी क्रिकेट नॉलेज से सिलेक्ट करो अपनी टीम और खेलो क्रिकेट
The content of our presentation are introduction, diversification, business model, user growth, revenue growth, competitors, reasons for growth, legality, fact, conclusion. Introduction. Dream 11 is a company which is in the sector of industrial sector of fantasy sports. Fantasy sports is an online gaming app in which users select their team virtually and real players are there but users select the play and points are given on calculating by statistical performance of the real players and the professional sports are included in it. Dream 11 work on the same concept and the founders are Harish Jain and Bhavit Seth. In 2001 they played fantasy sports of football league. They were big fan of football and in 2008 when IPL was inaugurated they wanted to play the fantasy sports of IPL but there was no app for that. So they decided to make app by one app by themselves and in 2008 they founded Dream 11 and by experimenting it on different markets 2012 they launched their app. They launched their app in Mumbai headquarters. The area served by this app is India. These are the different diversified sports that Dream 11 contains and these diversified sports are as partnered with different associations. First, basketball. Basketball is associated with NBA and Pro Kabaddi is associated with Pro Kabaddi League. And cricket, which is the major revenue portion of Dream 11, is partnered with ICC, IPL and Big Bash League. Football is partnered with every other league of football and hockey is partnered with Federation of Hockey India. Next. The business model of Dream 11 is very easy to understand. It is the first step is to sign up. Sign up is free for everyone and a coupon code is provided to every user who sign in as coupon code is used for referral to earn money. The second step is purchase point are given to the user. Some purchase point are given to the user to make his team for a particular contest. And in, for example, in cricket, 100 points are given to one user and he has to select one team accordingly. Different segments are there in one team like wicketkeeper, bowler, all-rounder and batsman. And they are divided into limited, they are given different prizes for them and accordingly they have to select that. Join the contest. One has to join the contest by paying for the contest. And there is a deadline for the contest. Before few hours of the contest, contest entry are closed. 20% of the total fee is collected as the income of Dream 11 and 80% is the reward for the winner.
Now looking at the growth, users growth. In 2014, only 10 lakh users were there of Dream 11, which increases to 20 lakh in 2016. 1.5 crores in 2017 and then 4 crores in 2018 and in 2019 they thought that they will reach the benchmark of 10 crore users. Next. Now the revenue growth. The data of the previous and revenue was not available so we took the revenue of last 2 years. In 2017-18 it was only 70 crores which increases to 228 crores in 2018-19. The net increase in revenue was 158 crores and which is a percentage increase of 230 crores. Now the competitors of Dream 11 are Daily Fantasy Cricket. Revenue of Daily Fantasy in 2017-18 was 30.8 crores. Cricket Win INR 14 crores. Fan Fight 5 to 6 crores and OA Captain 7 crores. Now looking at the reasons for growth, first mover advantage. Since the Dream 11 was the first app of its kind, so it has got the advantage of first mover, which attracts a lot of people to take part in it. Now aggressive marketing campaign. Dream 11 has left no gap for the marketing. They have hired Harsha Bhogle, the cricket expert, in 2017, and then MS Dhoni captain Cool in 2018, and in 2019 they were also the partner of Vivo IPL. Now cricket popularity among masses. Since hockey is a national sport, but the masses is more inclined toward the cricket. The love for cricket, and the people think that the cricket is a religion for them, it has also gave them a great advantage. Now chance of reward. One can make a money of putting only 30 rupees, means if you pay 30 rupees and you can get a chance to win 1 lakh rupees. So it also attracts a lot of greed, and the people are attracted towards it. Now free initial point. Since once when someone enrolls and sign up in Dream 11, they will get a 100 rupees free reward point, which one can use to play games. If you have put a 30 rupees in a game, and by any chance, by luck, you get to win rupees 10,000 or 1 lakh, then it's a fair chance and you can earn that also. Next. Legality. One of the user of Dream 11 has filed a case when he lost in a match. He filed a case against the Dream 11 that it's a gambling game, and it was taken to a court. After the hearing, the Punjab Haryana High Court had declared that it's not a game of gambling. And after that, the founder Harsh Jain has also stated that this is not a gaming but a sport, where people have to use their skills, their knowledge, and their ability to think the situation of a sports and then take a decision regarding that. It can be also stated that it is an equity market for sports. What they have done is that they have not made the people directly put their money on a team or on a particular team. They have made the people to use their skill, their knowledge to make their own team and then put their money on it. Next. Now these are some of the facts. Dream 11 is the highest in any sports gaming platform in India in terms of fantasy sports. As per the Indian Federation of Sports Gaming, Dream 11 hold 90% of the market share. They are in a partnership with ICC, International Cricket Council, National Basketball Association, Big Bash League, Pro Kabaddi League, International Hockey Federation. Recently, Stanview Capital has invested a lot of amount in the Dream 11, which make their valuation to $1 billion, and it's the first Indian gaming company to enter into the Unicorn Club. Next.
Conclusion. User increases from 10 lakh to 5.5 crore. As in a period of 6 years, it is a great growth for 5.4 crore users were increased in these years. High exponential growth is determined through the market strategies that they followed. They used very aggressive marketing strategies, and one of that was shown by us in the advertisement, the Dhoni campaign. Not considered as a gambling, as my friend already told that it is not considered as gambling. It is pure skill and knowledge that we use to earn in this game. More scope for diversification. Its region of working is only in India. It can be global, so the diversification can be increased. There is a more scope and more sports can be added to it. These are the references we took help from